Well, welcome to another edition of Girl Talk. Let's meet our wonderful ladies, Miss Deborah and Farah, Heather and Tracy, of course. And we got some hot topics for you. Y'all ready to jump in and
see what
we got? Woo, woo!
All right. Y'all heard about the Princeton mom?
No.
The lady that said you should spend 75% of your time while in college looking for a man.
Ooh. It sounds ugly, but isn't that where you'd want to find your husband?
Is like, this for someone who just goes to Princeton, or like
this is okay. For anyone on any college campus in America? 75%.
I'm not sure her parents are going to love to hear that. Of course, maybe she's on scholarship.
Yeah, and she's older. She's older. I think she's married, and you know, has kids, and she's like giving lessons to ladies, being like, this is where you need to meet.
Aww. But do we think life is all about getting a man? 75%? I mean, there's more to life than
that's
that.
That's true. I changed my opinion. If I had married the guy I met when I was in college, my mom would have cried at my wedding. So.
And he changed throughout those 4 years.
That's
how you are as a freshman, depending on how you are as a senior. But 75%,
that's a lot of time.
Yeah.
75% is a big, way big number. That large number should be focused on studies, mm-hmm. and the man should come later.
I really think you have to hope that as you're maturing in college, it's not all about that man, because some people don't ever find a man, and then their lives, you know, they feel like they're a failure by not being married, and you're not.
All right, personal past fashion faux pas. We happened to see a picture. I think my whole middle school year was a fashion faux pas. Like,
mine would have to be, I would wear the part down the middle and a braid on each side, or I would pull my hair back. You remember the banana clip?
Yeah. I didn't know that was a faux pas. Good to know.
Mine was, I crimped my hair. Do you remember the hair crimper?
Yes, I loved it.
I had really big hair, so it was like big, kind of like that. Giant shoulder pads that you can insert your shirt.
All right, here's a good one, Heather. I'm gonna ask you
this one.
Let's say that, you know, you're friends with a couple, and unfortunately they end up divorcing. Mm-hmm. You're friends with both. How do you pick who you're hanging out with?
Yeah, that's tough. I guess it depends on who you're closer with. I need to know what happened, which I'm sure is none of my business.
Yeah, but you're gonna pick a side.
So I can pick sides. I don't know. That's tough, but I mean, I guess
what do you think? Should you
you go with the woman?
Always go with the woman. Should you just not be friends with either of them?
Well, I think you can still continue to be friends, but I wouldn't hang out with them as much. If I saw them in passing, you know, I would still speak. But as far as hanging, you know, I would.
What if she's like, don't talk to him anymore?
I think it really depends on the circumstance.
Yeah.
I'm really doing it. I think it depends on how good of a friend you are.
Yeah, because when you never know what could happen. Like, they could, you know, we've had friends that have ended up getting back together.
Yeah. Oh, you should never say anything bad.
Yeah.
So if you're at home, you know,
if they get back together, who are they going to be mad at?
Yeah.
You.
Yeah. Even though at the time you were being a friend to that person, and then all of a sudden it's like, well, you were talking about my wife. And
I guess if they come to you, it can be like, we want to be friends with both of you.
Yeah.
Don't tell us, you know.
Yeah, that's just how we're going to do it.
We want to support both of you.
It'd be nice if you really didn't ever have to worry about that.
Yeah.
Everybody's marriages were great.
And they stayed together forever. Yeah, that would be a perfect world. That would be nice. What about obviously, you know, when the moms or women have a baby, they take maternity leave. What do y'all think about guys taking paternity leave? I'm not talking about like a week. I'm saying like 8 weeks, 6 weeks.
I think that would
be
great.
I do too. I think that it would be great for the daddy to be able to bond just like the mother. I don't know if it would work for them to be home together.
It would
be nice to have 16 weeks before the mother's home for 6.
The mother's home for
6 and the daddy's home for 6.
I love my husband. When he was home with me with the baby, I was like, I'd rather me be at work and you, like, we train. Because all of us just being here in the house while the baby's screaming is not fun.
Yeah, we're all cooped up.
We're all unhappy together. But someone should be happy. It should be me. My husband's he's great at helping. So.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Give them the confidence they can do it without help from their wife, and they have that time to bond, I think.
Yeah.
And then they feel needed.
Well, you ladies were great. We got a little gift for me from our Ultra Tan sponsors. This is the Ultra Skin Vitamin D Oil. It's supposed to be amazing. It's like your skin, like tightening and any lines and stuff. So thank you, Ultra Skin, for hooking us up.
Yeah.
And thank you so much for watching Girl Talk. That was fun. You
ladies
are great.
Yeah.